Basically a big book of fucking riddles. Riddles. Book contains important knowledge, my ass. Hey there guys, TheWeoneo here, and welcome back to Let's Play Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix. When last we met, we made it out of Twilight Town, fought a bunch of Heartless, climbed Yen-Sid's tower, and now here we are face to face with him. About to get a little bit of a tutorial on things going on in this game. We have to read that book like Master Yen-Sid. We've been asleep for a while, so we need to know what's been going on. Yeah, true facts. This is a strange tower, I wonder why it was built. Adventuring rule number 8, search every corner of a new place. Not a bad tip there, Goofy. All the mischief the king did years ago is recorded here. What, Fantasia? This book describes powerful spells. Okay. We got an okay treasure chest over here. We get a map. Fun times. Can't just barge in. That book contains important knowledge. Be sure to read it. Read more first. Yeah. So let's actually look at this book. Okay, so, yeah. The beginning. Each journey gives rise to a chance encounters, and each encounter brings forth a farewell. When a farewell leads to a journey, the worlds open their hearts. There are those chosen by the light and those ensnared by darkness. Friends who share the same bonds through their paths may differ. When you doubt the path trod thus far, when the hand you held is lost to you, gaze anew at the heart that once was, for all the answers are within. That doesn't make any fucking sense at all. Interlude. A long dream. A sad farewell hanging in the air that is between. What is reality? What is illusion? A path chosen by the young boy leads to his memories. When caught in the stream of the days and nights going past, gaze anew at your steps, for there all confusion will end. Essentially, this is telling you about Kingdom Hearts 1, Chain of Memories, and now this. Kind of in weird poem form. The future story. Will the day come when this battle born of confusion will end? It is different things to different people. Can reality be that which is hidden? Reason is mere existence. Still, memories can be believed. Be not afraid and trust your body to the soothing waves of your memories, and by your fleeting rest will be over and everything will begin. Basically a big book of fucking riddles. Riddles. Book contains important knowledge, my ass.
Wait a sec. How come the Heartless are still running around?
Your past endeavors did prevent an immense effusion of Heartless from the Great Darkness. Make no mistake about that. However, the Heartless are darkness made real, and darkness yet lingers in every heart. The Heartless are fewer, but while darkness exists in a single heart, it will be difficult to eliminate them.
Gorsh, that must mean if everybody's heart was full of light, them Heartless would go away.
Now, it is time to speak of the enemies that you will encounter. If one such as you, Donald, yields to the darkness in their heart, they too will become a Heartless. But you know this. The Heartless are always lurking and ever seeking to capture new hearts. Never let your guard down. Now then. At times, if someone with a strong heart and will, be they evil or good, becomes a Heartless, the empty shell they leave behind begins to act with a will of its own. An empty vessel whose heart has been stolen away. A spirit that goes on even as its body fades from existence, for you see, no bodies do not truly exist at all. No bodies may seem to have feelings, but this is a ruse. They only pretend to have hearts. You must not be deceived.
No bodies. They don't exist.
Now then, the being you see before you is known as a dusk. They are the most common form of nobody. But there are others, some larger, some with frightening and unique powers. Be vigilant. On your journey, you will meet an alarming number of dusks. They will all attempt to do you harm. Still, they are nothing but empty shells destined to return to darkness. But the beings you see before you now are different. These powerful nobodies have formed a group called Organization 13. It commands the lesser nobodies.
Organization 13.
While heartless act on instinct, nobodies function in a higher manner. They can think and plan, and it seems they are working towards a goal. What that goal is, we do not know. The king sensed the danger and journeyed forth to fight it. He found the Dark Realm's Keyblade and with it closed the door. Now he's traveling from world to world, fighting the Heartless as he seeks the answer to the riddle of the Nobodies and Organization 13.
Then I guess we better go find the king first.
But where could he be?
Well, we won't know till we look.
Yeah, and the king must know where Riku is, because the two of them were together in the Realm of Darkness when we closed the door. You know, after defeating Ansem.
So, before you go, you will need more suitable traveling clothes. Those look a bit too small for you. Through there, you'll find three good fairies. If you ask, they'll create for you appropriate garments.
Gosh, Sora, you sure are growing fast.
I guess.
So, Organization 13 are essentially the main bad guys of this game. Not necessarily the Heartless. But that is to say that we did fight a few members of Organization 13 in a Chain of Memories. Take time now to prepare. Yeah, I'm not reading none of that shit. Shakespeare thinking motherfucking book. I got time for that.
Me, you guys, Riku, and the king. I don't care who this organization is or what it's planning. With the five of us, I mean, six of us, there's nothing to worry about, right?
Yeah!
What the fuck does he mean by the five of us, I mean the six of us? There's us three, Riku the king. Does he mean Kairi or something? What the fuck's he talking about? Or is that like Roxas coming out and trying to be included or something? I don't fully understand that part. It's just, it's not that I don't, I guess, understand it. It's just that it can mean multiple things. That's kind of confusing. These clothes will help you only as much as your growth allows. Their true potential lies dormant. It's your job to unleash it. What? We've been told about you. Hurry up and try on your new clothes. That is, after you've prepared for your journey, of course. Did we get a chest in here? Yeah, we did. Okay. Once you've changed, you're off. Change clothes? Yeah. This is gonna be a whole new hell in a handbasket explaining this system.
Well, look who's here, dears. Sora, Donald, and Goofy.
Oh, if you're looking for clothes, you've come to the right place.
I'll do the designing. Oh, that will never do. Oh, now, dears. But don't you like this better?
Hold on.
Are you certain? Blue.
Personally, I'd prefer the blue one. That's just me.
Would you just decide?
Oh, well.
All right, then. Together now, dears. And no more squabbling. Oh, my.
Oh, it's lovely.
Oh, yes. He does look very dashing.
Now, those aren't ordinary garments.
They have very special powers. Take the orb, dear.
And watch what happens.
Whoa!
Whoa!
Two keyblades.
This journey's going to be twice as difficult as your last.
Your garments also have other powers, but you'll have to discover what they are as you continue on your journey.
Okay, I'll do my best, and thanks a lot.
Oh, and there's something else for you from Master Yen-Sid.
I'm back!
We get the Star Seeker. Increase maximum combo by 1 when in midair. And we get Valor Form. With Goofy's help, use the Drive command to change into Valor Form. So, as you can see, we now have a new meter down there, the Drive Gauge. The gauge on the lower right is consumed for transformation. It is powerful as it absorbs party member strength, but party members disappear while transformed. So essentially, I could go down here to Drive and do Valor Form. And what that'll do is it'll make Goofy disappear, but Sora will go into Valor Form and he'll have two Keyblades, and his combos become just absolutely insane. And as the game progresses, we will get more Drive Forms that do different things, that have different abilities, that do different properties, things like that. I'll explain them as we get them, but for now, I would say, when it comes to Drive Forms, use them as often as possible. Like, even if, like, you might say, like, oh, it's super powerful, you might want to fight, like, bosses with it. Things like that. But, wow. Oh, I see, okay. That's really cool. I never noticed that. All of these mirrors reflect what all the different forms are in the game. Image of utilizing strength to its fullest, that's valor. Image of utilizing magic. I guess I can, you know, spoil this, but that's wisdom form. An image of attaining old powers flows in your mind. I assume that's master form. An image of possessing all abilities. I assume that's ultimate form. No, that's ultimate. I don't know what that is. Possessing all abilities? Shoot, there's gotta be a form I'm forgetting. Image you overcome the power of darkness, that's a dark form. Okay, well, we'll see all those as we progress throughout the game. It's a very cool system, I like it. It's awesome. Oh, sorry, I think you dropped something. Must have fallen out of your pocket. What is it? Part of a picture? Is this a gift too? Oh, we don't know anything about that. But if you found it in your pocket, it must have something to do with your adventure. Hold on to it, dear. In fact, you should hold on to any other pieces you come across on your journey. I'll make sure to note them in my journal. You've obtained a puzzle piece. Puzzle pieces are scattered all over the world. Some can only be accessed after learning a certain ability. You can view collected pieces at Jiminy's journal. That's a final mix only thing, so I don't know too much about it. I guess we'll find out together.
So you guys ready to go?
Now, just a moment. Because of your previous endeavors, the worlds have returned to their original states. That means the pathways between them have disappeared.
How do we get around?
Do not fear. If what the king suspected proves true, the worlds have prepared new pathways along which you may travel. These pathways may be utilized by unlocking special gates. How these gates are opened, I'm afraid I do not know. However, the Keyblade will serve as your guide. When a beam of light radiates from the Keyblade, return to the gummy ship. Though the worlds may seem far apart and out of reach, they nonetheless remain connected by invisible ties, as do our hearts.
Our hearts are connected.
That is correct.
Got it.
But be warned, as you proceed, the Heartless and the Nobodies will be using their own paths. Corridors of darkness to travel from world to world. They may be attempting to link these dark pathways to the gates between the worlds.
Hey, that's not fair.
Now then, that is all the information I can give to you. Go forth, Sora, Donald, and Goofy. Everyone is waiting.
Okay, let's get going.
Master Yen-Sid!
We sure do appreciate the help.
My goodness, what's that? Haven't we seen this somewhere before?
Yes, dear. I wonder whose it was.
Oh, Malefa! No, we mustn't remember her name. Oh, dear. She was a mean old witch. Oh no, the memories are coming back. What'll we do? Oh, what'll we do?
Goodness,
oh,
dear.
Perhaps we should tell Master Yen-Sid.
Yes, that's what we must do. Hurry.
Howdy, Sora. How you doing?
It's your favorite gummy engineers here, ready for duty, Chip.
happy flying!
Only one?
That's no good.
Wait, I think it's a world we know.
Use the left stick to fly the gummy ship. Try approaching a world at the bottom of the screen. When you arrive at your destination, press triangle to land. Oh, the gummy map. It's so much better in this game. You actually have free reign to fly wherever you want, and kind of, you can see some world shrouded by darkness here. But there's also these green borders that you can't really pass. They kind of block you like giant bubbles. But gummy missions in general have improved tenfold in this game. So, we're leaving Twilight Town. We're now approaching Hollow Bastion. We're back!
Maleficent! Maleficent! Maybe they really did finish her off. Ooh, this castle sure ain't what I expected. No shine, no nothing. Oh, now what's gonna happen to our plan?
It's Hollow Bastion.
Gorsh, it looks kind of different now.
I hope Leon and the kid are doing okay.
Uh-oh, looks like we're gonna have to do some fighting.
Back in Hollow Bastion. And if you remember, this is exactly where we left Leon and his funky bunch of Final Fantasy characters. But now, actually, Hollow Bastion serves as your new Traverse Town in this game. It's kind of like the hub world where shops are and all that stuff. And that's kind of weird because, you know, it's like it was such a... It was basically like the main bad guy's hangout in the last game, but now it's kind of your hub world, kind of-ish. So, Huey, Dewey, and or Louie's accessory shop is back. Items from previously visited shops will come available at shops in large towns, aka Hollow Bastion. So if you ever see anything in a shop, it all comes flowing back to here, in case you don't remember where you actually saw it at. And yeah, they sell a whole bunch of kind of cool, interesting stuff. Things you may or may not want to buy. You can already buy an upgrade for Dolan and Gooby if you want. I actually think I might. Just so I can start, you know, doing that stuff. Anyways, form abilities are fixed, so... When you are in a different form, you have a whole bunch of new abilities, but you cannot change them, you cannot get rid of them. You can only gain new ones by leveling up a form. These abilities can be used even out of that particular form. When in a form, a second weapon can be equipped. One keyblade with strength abilities, two keyblades with strengths and abilities. Acquire abilities and strength from both weapons. From here, select a form, select a weapon to equip as a sub-weapon in that form. Very, very complicated, but very easy to use once you actually get into it and start looking at it. So these are all the things we get in Valor form, and whatever's in yellow is what levels up as you level that form. And as you level up this yellow ability, it means Sora will eventually learn it outside of that form. So, to get even more complicated with explaining this, if you level up, say, Valor form through killing Heartless, Sora will eventually learn High Jump. And each form has its own experience bar, but if you look at it and you highlight experience, for each attack dealt to the enemy in Valor form, 1 point of experience is gained. Every form gains experience through a different way, which is what's somewhat unique about it. So you can learn High Jump pretty early on in the game. It just requires you to use Valor form as much as possible. And that's why I say use forms as much as you can, because trust me, it helps. I don't know why I went into that. Customized. No, I wanted to go to items for Dolan. He's got the Mage's Staff. Let's equip him with Hammer Staff. Increase his strength for some reason, like he needs that. Goofy's got the Night Shield. Let's give him Adamant Shield. Can I sell this crap back to you? Nope, can't sell basic weapons. Okay, no problem then. Let's just keep exploring Hall of Bastion then, I guess. Talk to Moogles in towns. They can synthesize items with various materials. Collect materials used for item synthesis to create various items. So here's your synthesized shop. Obtain elixir for completing one collection. Yeah, and as usual, you hand over materials so that you don't necessarily have to have them in your item list. Moogle holds onto them until you actually need them for synthesizing. But as you can see, we don't have any recipes to synthesize with yet. Kind of. Scrooge McDuck. Uncle Scrooge. Or who? He's Donald's uncle, a business tycoon. Before the Heartless showed up, he traveled the worlds on a gummy ship with the king. He was helping to set up a traffic system. A transit system. What's all the racket? Why, if it isn't Donald. And Goofy, hello lads. You all look hale and hearty. So do you, Uncle Scrooge. If only I were. I cannot seem to recreate my favorite old-time ice cream. I'd make millions if I just got it right. Terrible. I believe what he's trying to create is sea salt ice cream, which has been a big theme throughout the game so far. Leon and the others are in the burrow. They went to Merlin's house. The shop is actually a giant refrigerator. This ice blocks are going to make good ice cream. What do you sell? Oh, you're the potions and shit. The guy I'll never talk to. I see that sticker up there too, but I can't reach it unless I have High Jump. Some nobodies. So let's try out that Valor form, shall we? Since we have a full drive gauge, might as well. As you can see, Sora is quite deadly when in these forms. He doesn't mess around too much. Can deal out tons of damage in a short amount of time.
Hey, you guys! I see you're still in top form.
What'd you expect? Looks like you're doing okay.
Well, what did you expect?
How are the others?
Great!
Hey, Yuffie. Have you seen the King and Riku?
Nope. But I had a feeling I'd see you guys again.
We may never meet again, but we'll never forget each other.
Is that supposed to be Leon? Everybody's working on stuff over at Merlin's house. Come on!
As you can see, if you enter a form and you then enter a cutscene, you are still in that form in the cutscene. It's a very interesting detail. We got a map of Hollow Bastion, of the marketplace area of Hollow Bastion. That's another thing to note in this game, is that worlds are way bigger than they were in the than in Kingdom Hearts. Like, worlds are massive in this game. Well, I say massive, but that's massive compared to Kingdom Hearts 1. Well, diddle-da-damn, I did not get I didn't get a level up for Valor Form right there. I probably got pretty close to it, though. Okay, so I'm just gonna look for some more Heartless in this area. So I know they're here, those sons of bitches. Let me check my status. Actually, how close was I to getting a level up for that? Oh, okay. I needed 30 more hits with Valor Form to get a level up on it. That was pretty good then. We'll have high jump in no time. Elixir, yeah, okay. That's all it's telling me that's new. This is Merlin's house.
Meet the Hollow Bastion Restoration Committee.
We missed you.
Well, if you ain't in top shape.
I knew it.
Knew what?
A while back, everyone suddenly remembered you guys, all at the same time.
You remembered? Wait, does that mean you forgot about us?
Ouch!
So where have you guys been all this time?
We were sleeping.
Where? In cold storage?
It doesn't matter. This is great. Everyone's together again.
So, we're trying to find Riku and the King. Have you seen him? Right.
Sorry, but let us know if there's anything we can do to help, okay?
Okay, thanks.
Don't go thanking us just yet.
Hollow Bastion's got a problem. A big problem.
You mean, like, nobodies? And Heartless?
That's right!
Sounds like you could use our help.
Then let's cut to the chase. Sora, Donald, Goofy, we were hoping the three of you might give us a hand around here.
Like we're gonna say no?
I forgot who I'm dealing with.
Hey, what do you mean by that?
Just think of it as a sort of Leon compliment.
Follow me to the Bailey. There's something you need to see.
Oh, I thought it was you. Right on time.
It's Merlin!
Sora and the gang said they're gonna help out.
Splendid. We'll count on you.
Right.
Ah, yes. Did you give them the cards, dear?
Oh. Here. They're presents for you. Leon thought you might like to have them.
Hollow Bastion Restoration Committee Honorary Member.
What was your plans?
Kinda cool, huh?
Hey, thanks, Leah. Huh? Oh, no! We're supposed to be at the Bailey.
I know what you're all thinking. As soon as Merlin said cards, we all got triggered for a moment. What about your magic? Huh? Oh, that's right. We haven't done any magics thus far, and I haven't explained the mana system because this fucking game gives you tutorials out the ass. Maybe you forgot it while you're asleep. Now what am I to do with you? I suppose I'll have to lend you a few spells, but be careful with them. Thanks, Merlin. To the Bailey and fast. We get the membership card. A membership card of the Holobastion Restoration Committee. A rare honorary membership card. We get Blizzard Element. Unleashes ice crystals at the target used for magic command. Didn't he say a few spells? He gave us one. He gave us Blizzard. The magic command has been added. Consume MP from the gauge in the bottom right to use magic. Press L1 for shortcut commands. MP is restored at save points and also after a fixed period of time, even after full consumption. So yeah, it's kind of hard to explain, but as you can see, I can do magic and my meter goes down a little bit, right? I think after some time it restores itself, maybe? But if you use it continuously, as you can see, you also have magic combos now. Once it's depleted, it will turn pink and you can no longer use magic until it, it's done recharging. Also, you might notice that yellow sparks going into the drive gauge. When you're out of mana and your mana is doing its recharge, your drive gauge, I think, refills twice as fast. So what you're going to see is a really weird strategy I use sometimes where I'll just use magic just to get rid of mana just so I can get the double recharge on drive gauge. And that's why I can't wait till we learn Cure, because Cure uses your entire mana bar no matter what. So it's just like an auto double drive gauge activator, but you gotta use it, you know, strategically. You don't want to heal when you don't need it and then have your mana recharging when you actually need a heal, things like that. But anyways, that's enough of that. Oh, now it's gonna explain it. When MP is empty, MP will charge until full. From customized select character setup, set a magic spell, select MP charge. Yeah. Oh. You can set up so that it doesn't charge after certain spells, but I don't know why the fuck you'd do that. That seems stupid, but anyway. Maybe someone out there uses it and is like, hey! Did I save? I think I did. Anyways, I'll save again. Yeah, we saved. Alright, anyways, let's end this episode. Guys, I'm sorry I had to explain so much, but I just feel like the tutorials just come naturally to me sometimes. Thank you so much for watching. This has been your host, as per usual, TheWeoneo. Next time, we'll explore Holobastion a little bit more and see exactly what is up with Leon and this Bailey. So, see you then, TheWeoneo. Bye-bye for now.